Hello, and welcome to our winter instrumental concert at Ipswich Middle School. I'm Michael Coelho, director of orchestras here, and it's my pleasure to introduce you to our new sixth grade orchestra. These students have been working incredibly hard this semester, and I couldn't be prouder of the growth of each individual musician. Our next piece is our sequel to the famed Dragon Hunter that they performed in fifth grade, and it will feature guest percussionists. Please welcome Mr. Jamie Fremont-Smith on percussion for our performance of Dragon Slayer.
Some fiddling, and our first piece does just that, incorporating the sounds of southern fiddling for all instruments of the orchestra. Here's Stone Mountain Stone.
Thank you. for his scores primarily in heavy action films like Star Wars, Jurassic Park, Indiana Jones, Superman, and many, many more. Somewhere in My Memory highlights the composer's ability to write in any style necessary. Originally for orchestra and choir, the lyrics are as follows. Candles in the window, shadows painting the ceiling, gazing at the fire glow, feeling that gingerbread feeling. Precious moments, special people, happy faces I can see. Somewhere in my memory, Christmas joys all around me, living in my memory. All of the music, all of the magic, all of the family home here with me. Please enjoy our performance of Somewhere in My Memory.
Jazz and rock musician in his early career, and he received several awards when playing with various bands during the 70s and 80s. Most notably, however, the first movement of his piece, the Palladio, was used in a series of jewelry commercials in the 1990s. It is a powerful piece. It sweeps up the listener and pulls them along as it builds with emotion and suspense. Please enjoy Carl Jenkins' Palladio.
Thank you. Hello.
Hi, my name is Mr. Lee. Some of you might not know me yet because these are sixth graders are, I shouldn't say new now that it's almost Christmas, but new to the building. If you are the lovely parent, grandparent, or aunt and uncle of one of these fine young individuals, I'd love to actually get the opportunity to meet you after the concert, so I'll be around helping with the jazz band, but I'm Mr. Lee. That was Entry of the Nobleman by Ralph Ford. Our next piece we're going to play for you is a Christmas tune, Up on the Rooftop, or Up on the Housetop, I guess depends on what part of the country you're from. And in the sixth grade band, during our lessons, we really work on our technique and advancing our musicianship quality. So we talk about what exactly makes a composition or what exactly makes an arrangement. So we took the melody and together we kind of made this arrangement. It says Mr. Lee in the sixth grade band because I kind of coached them along on which instrument would sound good on which part. But for the most part, they had all the ideas of who should play when. So for example, you'll hear a part where the saxophones and trombones take over the melody for a bit and then they're answered by the flutes. We kind of worked that out in class. One thing that we thought would be cool is we learn about the relative minor scale in sixth grade. So a lot of times you hear a familiar major scale. We decided to take the tune and also play it in a minor scale. So it kind of sounds like Nightmare Before Christmas in the middle, but it's very interesting. Ethan Dixon on saxophone is going to demonstrate for you his G major scale. Here. Yep, you can go ahead now. Yep, G, A, B. Good, so there's the G major scale, and if you start on E or on La, if you're familiar with music syllables, it makes a minor scale by using the same notes. So Ethan, can you play one starting on E now? Good, nice job. How about a round of applause for Ethan Dixon on the saxophone? Nice job, man. So here is Up on the Rooftop, with a little bit of minor inflection for you. Thank you. Up next is the 7th and 8th grade band under the direction of Miss Lisa Palan. Thank you.
Hello. Oh, perfect, we're on. The Colonel Bogey March is a British march that was composed in 1914 by Lieutenant F.J. Ricketts, 1881 through 1945, pen name Kenneth J. Alford, a British Army bandmaster who later became the director of music for the Royal Marines at Plymouth. The sheet music was a million seller, and the march was recorded many times. At the start of World War II, Colonel Bogey became part of the British way of life when the tune was set to a popular song.
English composer Malcolm Arnold added a counter march, which he titled the River Kwai March, for the 1957 dramatic film The Bridge on the River Kwai, set during World War II. The two marches were recorded together by Mitch Miller as March from the River Kwai / Colonel Bogey. While Mr. Arnold did use Colonel Bogey in his score for the film, it was only the first theme and a bit of the second theme of Colonel Bogey, whistled unaccompanied by the British prisoners several times as they marched into prison camp.
Our next piece is The Skater's Waltz. It was written by Emile Waldafal in 1882. He was known as the Waltz King of Paris. This song has been used in dozens of movies, TV shows, and commercials. He was inspired to write this music while watching skaters at a public rink in Paris.
Thank you. is a cultural setting of the traditional Ukrainian bell carol. This unique arrangement celebrates the rich heritage of the American popular music. Beginning with a quote from John Philip Sousa, "The Stars and Stripes Forever" provides a sparkling and energetic arrangement.
Thank you so much. We just have a quick transition to chamber orchestra. Thank you for your patience.
Famous myths, legends, fairy tales, and stories from all over the world shape cultures, mold ethics, and teach lessons for years to come. Every popular tale has a beginning adventure, a fantasy, and the ultimate conflict between good and evil. Mythos, written by Sun He Nu Bold, includes many of these themes, which are inspired by age-old fables, magical sagas, and the epic dramas of today. Accompanied by our own artwork depicting these themes, please enjoy Mythos.
Thank you.
So this next tune and final tune is just a sort of holiday treat. We wrestled with the title for a while, but it's a fantastic arrangement of holiday tunes. And it actually features the viola section completely, where the melody is only in the violas. So please enjoy Santa Plays the Viola.
Thank you so much for your patience. This is our middle school jazz orchestra. Thank you, and we're going to feature on this first number, Elijah Bergner is going to do some improvising on, this is called Change Up, and it's a variation on I've Got Rhythm Changes, which is a standard for improvisation. So we're going to ask Elijah to mess around with that a little bit. This is by Carl Strum, and it's called Change Up.
Thank you.
Eliza Berger on trumpet. Now for a number from the man who freed music, Herbie Hancock. This is a tricky one. I want to thank Mr. Lee for all his work with the rhythm section on this. He worked really hard, as did our wonderful bass players, Ella and Stella, and our wonderful drummer, Ethan. This is a tough one. This is Watermelon Man. We're going to feature Nadine Kelly on alto. Josiah Scarano on the violin, we're going to feature Ronan Miner on the trombone, and we're going to feature Mark Norris on the trombone on this one. But before we get into this last centerpiece tune, I'd just like to thank all of you for all your support without which we couldn't have done this, and our wonderful adjunct faculty and all of my colleagues and Mr. Lee for all your help with music selection and rhythm work and all the other stuff that we've been doing together. It's been great fun. So keep up the good work out there. Have a great holiday. And this is our final piece called Centerpiece.